Egyptian or Egyptology, they believe that the universe was sung into creation. In Hinduism, or Buddhism, and Eastern philosophy, there are the six aspects of Om, and that's why that relationship between six and three is so important. 333, 666. And the Omani Padme Hum. And notice that shape that the Om is depicted therein. That is not an accidental shape. The 6 days of creation in Christianity tells us the same thing, and at the same time links Christianity inextricably to sacred geometry. Remember, sacred doesn't mean wishy-washy religious, it means fixed. Fixed geometry, as fixed by the divine creator. Doesn't mean religious, sacred. The word of sound, word and word was sound. And in Egyptology, we have the six aspects of the all-seeing eye of Horus. And very quickly you realize that these are six resonance ratios. It's all to do with sound. That's why the Egyptians used two as their main common denominator in all their mathematics, because everything they did was to do with resonance and harmonics. And they used two because two is the resonant harmonic ratio that controls it. But what is sound? Can we look at sound? Can we see sound? There's some brilliant guys that developed a thing called the cymoscope in recent years. I forgot to plug this in. Let me just quickly do this. On the metal plate, and you put sound frequencies through it, and what it does, it creates these perfect, beautiful patterns, and they change the shape of the shapes that are created by the different sound frequencies. That was introduced to us by
the Chladni figures.
No, well, Chladni originally, but more recently by, I have a complete blank, excuse me, in the 60s and 70s.
Hans Jenny from Cymatics.
Hans Jenny, thank you.
See?
Hans Jenny, the Cymatics, and he coined the phrase Cymatics, and many of you will be familiar with it, and it's just really spectacular what sound does, how it turns sound into physical form and shape. And if you take it a step further, these guys created a thing called a cymoscope that you can actually do a lot more with. In fact, they've started analyzing the language of dolphins with this thing, and recognize that dolphins have specific words for things that they communicate with. And this you can all do with the cymoscope. So this is what it looks like when you put a human voice into a cymoscope to show you how it manifests physical form and shape. Beautiful. So every time you speak, every sound you make manifests itself in an ever-growing and expanding bubble that just keeps going and going and affecting all things around you in ways that you can't even imagine. Every word you speak, every sound you make affects everything around you. When you take one of those sound bubbles and you cut it in half, it's a three-dimensional thing. Remember, it's not just a flat two-dimensional thing. It goes in all directions. If you take that sound bubble, you cut it in half, what do you get? Now, this beautiful cross-section on the right here. When you look at the cross section, what do you see? Look at that. Suddenly you start seeing the cross appearing out of the sound bubble, and you realize that one of the most commonly used symbol in religion actually emanates out of the sound that comes out of our mouths. And if you drill even deeper into that, it becomes quite startling, and you realize where they got their symbol from. The cross in a circle. After all, sound is the primordial creative source. It is the shape of God, the Creator. And I'm talking about God with a big G, not the little ones with a small g that know how to clone things and manipulate them. This is a spectacular discovery. Look at these beautiful spheres, these sound waves that roll away, the resonance, the coherence that moves away from that original source in all direction at the same time, connecting everything and affecting everything from that moment that sound is made. You have connected to everything in the universe from that instant. It doesn't take 100 light years for that sound you made to reach anywhere else in the universe. It actually reaches there virtually instantly. And that's based on a whole different understanding of what sound really does. I know it's tough for some physicists to deal with in the mainstream physics. And now you realize how accurate these guys were when they carved these crosses in circles and called them Mabona, Lord of Light. They knew stuff we're only recently beginning to rediscover. And you start seeing the Coptic and the pagan crosses. Whoever designed those knew exactly what they were basing it on. They understood all this stuff. And this is why these symbols carry so much energy. Remember that every symbol, every drawing, every image you look at carries energy. It reflects energy. It's not just a symbol or a thing or your signature or whatever. Everything, every image has energy encoded in it. And it's the energy that comes out of it that affects everything around it, including the people that observe it. Sound heals. Here's a beautiful image of these sound waves, these coherent waves coming across a human cell, showing you how it affects the surface on that cell and can either cause ease or dis-ease. The principles of resonance are very important in our lives because that is the prime resonance frequency is attributed to everything that exists. Everything has a prime resonant frequency at which it vibrates and resonates, like the whole body, like the cells and organs. The cells in the body resonate at around 1,000 hertz. Organs like the heart resonate around 100 hertz. And the whole body resonates between 7 and 10 hertz. The prime resonant frequency of everything is based on that specific organ. Important to note that 7 and 10 at which our bodies resonate is very close to the frequency at which Mother Earth or Gaia resonates at. And therefore we need to get into harmonic resonance with Earth so that we are at ease with Mother Earth and not in dis-ease with Mother Earth and therefore cannot become sick. And these things become more and more important as we grow into this knowledge. Herbert Froelich was very important in sharing some of this information, especially coherence. And he says it's generally believed that biological coherence is the means by which the body integrates processes such as growth, injury, repair, and defense. But he also believed that sound is always the precursor to electromagnetism. Well, it says so in the first three verses of the Bible. It's the sound of God that created the entire electromagnetic field. The sound, nothing else. So can this process be reversed so that we can create everything out of sound? If sound is a primordial creative source, we should be able to use sound to do everything. And now it starts to link to my discoveries in South Africa. From this moment on, you can start seeing why I get so excited about the stuff that I've been talking about until now. Otherwise, it would be a little weird. Why is he talking about all this stuff while he should be talking about ancient ruins? Because I discovered that the ancient ruins are sound energy sources. Once again, highlighting how much these ancients knew. They were way ahead of the pack. It's so exciting. So this guy took it to extremes. He He wired a LED lights to a speaker and found that if you expose the speaker to very noisy areas, it actually reverses the process. The coil, the speaker vibrates the coil and sends the energy back and actually lights up the LED lamp. I haven't tested this, but I'm not going to, you know, not believe it because it makes sense to me. So go and try it. We live in an electromagnetic universe where everything spins and vibrates and resonates. It appears out of thin air, out of a point or a vacuum. Magically, it just appears out of nothing. Just like banks create money
just
out of
like
thin air.
Our money.
That's the one thing that they have in common. Thank you, Danny. You had a rough day, sorry. And it's the spinning and vibrating and resonance that allows us to measure all this stuff in the electromagnetic universe. And then we teach our students that, well, we can only talk about the stuff that we can measure. All the stuff we can't measure, we can't talk about, and therefore probably doesn't exist. And that's just the most incredible nonsense that we can come up with, isn't it? I'm sure every one of you understands what I'm talking about. It's just insane. So I'm saying just because you can't see it, it doesn't exist. In that case, I can say to you, if you think that if you can't see it, it doesn't exist, you must be a big... I don't know, did you get that?
Yeah.
But it can make us sick. That's why it doesn't show.
So we also told that the universe keeps expanding. And this electromagnetic universe that we find ourselves in, and because it keeps expanding, common physics tells us, well, if it's expanding, something must be contracting for the universe to expand. And yet quantum physics tells us, well, that's not necessarily necessary anymore. And these two conflicting philosophies are at odds with each other. So who's blowing up the universe if it keeps expanding? What if nothing was blowing up the universe? Those are the fundamentals of quantum physics. That there can be nothing and something gets created out of that nothing. An infinite amount of things get created out of this nothing. And you don't have to have contraction to have expansion. That's an old kind of way of thinking about the nature of reality. We've got to get out of that kind of paradigm. So what if I told you that it is actually us that is blowing up the universe? Not just us, but it's actually our consciousness. The stuff that we find so difficult to define. What is this consciousness that keeps blowing it up? We are the things, we are the people, we are the consciousness that keeps blowing up the universe. You don't need something to contract. And that means that God is within us. God is within you. Once again, all the great masters of the past have told us the same story. God is within you. You can do anything if you believe, if you understand. You can move mountains, you can do all these great things. Because you are one with God. God is within you. And guess what? All this knowledge and information has been encoded and kept by artists and knowledge and great minds of the past in such spectacular fashion, but sometimes it gets presented right in front of our eyes and we can't even see it. This is one of the best examples of God is within you. Michelangelo's wonderful drawing, wonderful painting in the Sistine Chapel. The creation of Adam. There's God within your brain. You are the creator. Through your mind you can create. You don't need anything from outside. Look at Adam, just doing nothing. Very camp. And when you start looking at the work of William Shakespeare, Leonardo da Vinci, there are hundreds and thousands of encoded works, not just art, not just ancient works like Shakespeare, but modern movies are totally and utterly encoded with all this knowledge and information in ways that will blow your mind. And this presentation is far too short for that. So go and check out Willem de Swart's work on his website called secretnumbers.org. Secretnumbers.org. And he talks about the movies and how they are encoded with all this advanced knowledge. It is spectacular.
Knowingly?
I beg your pardon?
They've been encoded knowingly?
Absolutely, knowingly. This is a big thing. I'm just going to quickly tell you what I found out, because otherwise we're going to spend an hour easily talking about this. We can spend a day talking about this, because it gets so exciting when you see what's going on. Once you see what's going on, it's like, oh my God, I can't believe it. It's all around us. It's just everywhere, and we just can't see it. But when you see it, suddenly you realize what's going on. When you know the truth, When you have seen the light and you know the truth, you have to tell it. You have to share it with others. If you don't, it will consume you and it will kill you. Okay, so I'm giving you this bit of advice from me. Go out and tell others. Otherwise, you're going to die. You're going to die in any case. Or maybe. Maybe some of you are these weird ETs that live forever. But what I found is that if you know stuff and if you come into the light and you become enlightened, you've got to share that information with others. It's just one of those things. So I believe that there's an inner secret sanctum of the Freemasons, which actually refer to themselves as the Templars. So, and they are responsible for this encoding of this advanced knowledge into the movies in Hollywood. I don't know how they do it, but they do it. They have their ways. It is so specific. It is so exact. It is word specific. It's time code specific. It's at 55 minutes and 69 seconds he says X, Y, and Z. It is spectacular. And it is directly linked to the tarot cards, the 22 tarot cards, and all the archetypes, and all the information that is encoded in the tarot cards. That is pretty much all the knowledge of the entire universe and everything that's ever occurred in it. It is mind-blowing, people. It's just when that stuff starts to hit you, and you realize how deep that knowledge is, you just got to ask yourself, who were these people that encoded all the stuff? The tarot cards. Who were those guys that created the tarot cards? They knew everything. And we're just slowly but surely stringing onto this little, you know, little bait and getting more and more bigger handle on the bigger picture. So I believe the movies are encoded to help us wake up subconsciously and subliminally, help reactivate our consciousness and our DNA and other ways. Sound and frequency are the master key. Sound can do everything, all these things. All these amazing things that sound can do. So let's have a first look. First of all, brand new discovery by a German pharmaceutical company that says this releases new plasma light that kills bacteria, viruses, and fungus. And it can even kill cancer. Wow, isn't that amazing? And they don't tell you there's just frequencies of light, so they have to give it a funky name like plasma light. And it's very, very expensive. And only the richest of the rich with the best hospital plans can afford this because it's plasma light. Don't try it at home. It's not just ordinary light. It's plasma light. Well, guess what? This guy did it a long, long time ago. Royal Rife cured all disease with light, sound, electromagnetic frequencies. He had it all worked out. He killed everything you can imagine. Cured people from anything. Unfortunately, he didn't want to work too closely with the pharmaceutical companies. So guess what happened to him? We crush stones, kidney stones, but, you know, so we don't have to operate. So take it to the next level. Can we crush bigger stones? If we can crush kidney stones with sound, of course we can. John Keeley, in 1888, crushed 20-ton giant blocks with sound frequencies. He drilled precision holes, absolutely precision holes with sound frequencies. He levitated them with sound. He did all this stuff with sound. And in fact, it's him that gave us a clue that the sound device has to be calibrated to the body frequency of your body. That's why I figured out that those guards in Egypt had to carry the ankh that was calibrated to the frequency of their own body. John Keeley gave me that clue in some of his work.
John Burrell Keeley?
Yeah. And this was his musical dinosphere that he did all this magical stuff with. Magic. He could do absolutely magic. He was a real magician.